Hello everybody, I am not dead yet, and yesterday I posted a poll on both my community tab and my Instagram asking which video you guys wanted to see first, and on YouTube I got Eddie Hall eating a slice of humble pie after his loss to Thor, whereas on Instagram I got more people interested in me wanting to talk about KSI saying that he could beat Hafþór Bjornsson in a fight. So what I decided to do is I'll film this one, and this is the one that's going to come out first, the one on KSI, you've read the title, and then the one on Eddie Hall will come out after this, because Thor has actually, as of now, posted a response video to Eddie, so I'm going to react to both of them and give my thoughts on it. So be on the lookout for that, make sure to subscribe if you're interested in that so you do not miss it and you're one of the first people to figure out when I post it. All that jazz. But today, what ended up happening a while ago was Thor posted on his Instagram a repost of Lad Bible that said KSI thinks he could beat the Mountain in a boxing match despite the massive weight difference. And then if you scroll to the side, swipe, and there's a quote from KSI that says, "Yes, bro, he'd be slow. You have to be fast. In and out, in and out. One of those things because he's slow. While he's recharging to strike, you can hit him." So what do I think of that? Honestly, I think he's 100% right. That's exactly how you fight a bigger fighter. I don't want to say a taller fighter, because there's a difference between a taller fighter and a heavier fighter. You can have tall people that are relatively lanky and very quick on your feet, and in and out just doesn't work with them. In fact, the tall, lanky fighters with long arms are the people who do in and out the best. Some of the people that come to mind for me are Sugar Ray Leonard. Sugar Ray Leonard had amazing footwork for his height and frame. But when you fight someone heavier who is a lot more just pure raw power, that is what you want to do. You want to kind of get in and then make him miss and punish him for that. You counter speed with power and power with speed. What does that mean? Well, when you have someone who's really fast zipping around you like that, you don't want to try and chase them. If Thor was fighting KSI and he was bouncing around, zipping around the ring, in and out, like he said, what Thor would need to do is he would have to wait, kind of shell up, maybe block some punches, and then wait for a good opportunity to counter him, get rid of the momentum, and just kind of stall him, stun him, stop him from kind of getting into that groove. I used to fight somebody who was really short, but really fast, super speed, lightning fast hands. He wouldn't really hurt you so much as he would slowly accumulate damage. It wouldn't be this one like, "Oh, what was that?" It'd be like, "Boom, boom, 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 boom," and you'd be like, whoa. He'd hit you like 12 times before you realize what hit him, or what hit you. And so the way you counter that is you would see him coming, and right as he would step in, solid counter. Completely disrupt his rhythm, and then you'd go after him. I myself consider myself to be sort of a hybrid athlete when it comes to speed versus power. I'm not the biggest, strongest person in the room, but I'm also not 100% speed. I'm a mix of both, and I turn up one versus the other depending on who I'm fighting. So if I was fighting somebody who was way bigger than me, right, then I would obviously rely a little bit more on speed than standing there and slugging it with the guy. And if I was fighting that shorter guy that I mentioned previously who is way faster than me, I would calm down, block. I gotta take this. You literally caught me right in the middle of filming. I'm filming a video right now. They've been construction all day, and then I get a little bit of a break. I'm like 3.5 minutes into this video, and then you just do 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 do. Say hi to the camera, Josh.
This sounds like a Greg message, because I didn't hear any intro to what you said. All I heard was just this. It was just like, do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I've been working all day, decided to send me a call, and I'm like, what is the context?
Yeah, no, I'm filming a video. So there's a bunch of people doing construction all day. It's finally quiet. And then, right in the middle of it, I was talking about boxing, and then just boom, call. We're currently recording, by the way. I'll probably put some of this into the video. I don't know how much, but yeah.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'll hang up, but I was actually freaking out that I ruined your footage, because if somebody calls me, my footage is gone.
Oh, really? No. I roll with the punches.
Okay. Freaking. Okay, so when do you want to call?
I don't know. Give me like 10 minutes.
Bro, you're always up 10.
Yeah, and then I also have to go grocery shopping, so I'm just like...
Well, I mean, we can always, like, do a longer call another day, but, like, just do, like, an initial thing or whatever.
Yeah, I'd be fine with that. Again, we'll figure it out.
Alright.
Yeah, give me like 10 minutes, cause I literally they stopped construction or like the loud jackhammer construction so I can film. So I'm like, okay, wait, I'll film in the meantime. Like 3 minutes in, you call.
Okay, yeah. All right, well, I'll just look out for a text.
Sounds good. Okay, so yeah, that was that. Anyway, what was I saying? What was I saying? Give me a sec. Okay, right, so if I was fighting a smaller guy that was shorter than me and super speedy, you don't want to chase him. The more you chase someone like that, the more tired you get, and the more you play into their ballpark. So the same way you counter power with speed, and speed with power, you counter movement with, if he gives you movement, you give him no movement, and vice versa. So if he's zipping around the ring back and forth, you don't give him movement. You stay put, you stay where you are, and staying in the middle there will allow you to better track him to finally set up that counter. Vice versa for that, you when you're fighting one of those bigger fighters, you want to make it hard for him to track you, so you zip around. The strategy and general idea behind what KSI is saying is 100% valid and really good, actually. It's what you would have to do to fight someone like that. And so to add on to that strategy too, I would say ignore the head entirely. He is too tall. And this is for any shorter fighter. This is general advice for any shorter fighter. Even if they're only 3 to 4 inches taller than you, do not headhunt. That is how they trick you. That is how they get you into their rhythm. That is how they allowed to slip and get away with stuff. What you want to do is focus on the body, focus on piling on fast and powerful punches. Go heavy, overwhelm them, and build up the damage over time. Because the more that you build up that damage, the more that you punch their body and the more you hurt them, the more it takes away their legs, it makes it harder for them to move, their legs turn to jelly, and the more that it takes away their stamina. You punch them, they go, ugh! You punch the wind out of them, and it makes it harder for them to not only move because of the legs, but also to fight back. You are taking away their ability to defend against you, and the more that happens, the more you can build up that momentum, and the more the fight tips in your favor. Now, in terms... Now, in terms of Thor specific...
Later. 12 o'clock midnight.
Okay, so it's been a couple hours and we're back. But in terms of Thor specifically, I believe one of the best things for a shorter fighter to do is overwhelm the person. Go full on aggression and full on speed and pile on that damage. Because like I said, you especially when you have such a weight disadvantage, you can't rely on the one punch massive knockout. You gotta kind of accumulate that damage and then... there's a famous saying in boxing where it's if you hit the body enough, the head will come to you. It's like that scene from Rocky IV where Rocky's chopping at the tree. That's exactly what it is. You chop at the tree with your body shots to eventually make it topple down and present the head to you. Present the chin, which can hopefully let you finish them off. In terms of Thor, Thor is a pretty decent boxer, especially for the amount of time that he's been doing it. But I don't think he has the experience needed to be able to keep a calm and level head under serious pressure. He's never really fought, to my knowledge, someone that really took the fight to him, that just said, screw it, I don't care if I get hit, I don't care if I'm being risky, I'm going to use all of the tools at my disposal and just attack. And that is how you can often overwhelm a taller opponent. There are a lot of times in fights where the taller opponent is doing really good at, keeping range until the shorter fighter just says screw it and bum rushes them. Now, this isn't something that you can rely on for the entirety of a fight, but it only really needs to work once. And with Thor, I truly do believe that if you can get the drop on him and truly overwhelm him, he won't really be able to know what's happening. So yeah, honestly speaking, when it comes to that post specifically, the strategy presented by KSI is a valid one. If he were to fight someone like Thor, that is how you would go about doing it. Now, I know the obvious question. Do I think KSI is good enough to execute that strategy? Do I think he's good enough to be able to take on Thor with the strategy that we laid out? No. Like, are you fucking kidding me? No. Like, I've seen some people say that, like, KSI's got some talent. He's decent. But, like, it's the mountain we're talking about. Let me make one thing clear. KSI is not a good boxer. He doesn't have talent. Or talent in the sense that people are saying, like, he's especially gifted in the sport. He's not good. In fact, I wouldn't even go so far as to say he's decent. I would say that KSI is a shitty boxer. I went back just before I made this video and rewatched the highlights of his fight with Logan Paul, and he's really bad. Like, sure, he may know what to do in theory, but there's no way in hell he's going to be able to put that into practice. His boxing style is bull rush forward, chin up, and windmill haymakers. He's got zero defense, zero footwork, and zero showcase of an ability to put to actually apply a strategy like that in a fight. I am someone who truly believed that Logan Paul thoroughly beat KSI both times they stepped into the ring. If you want to see my first ever YouTube video that I posted, it was my thoughts on Logan Paul versus KSI. It's I'll link it wherever. But I believe that KSI lost both of those matches because he just didn't have the skill. And so if he can't, and he's been knocked down and put on his ass by Logan Paul. If Logan Paul can put KSI on his ass, the mountain's going to punch his head off his shoulders. He's not going to have an ass by the time he's done fighting the mountain. In order to fight someone like the mountain, when you're smaller like that, when you have that massive weight disadvantage, it's not the height disadvantage that's a problem, and I've said it before, it's the weight disadvantage, and that doesn't mean weight means everything in a fight. I truly do believe that weight is one advantage among many, but it is still an advantage that needs to be taken into account. KSI is not the one to do it. He does not have you in order to beat the mountain with such a significant weight disadvantage. You would need to perfectly execute that strategy, and I just do not believe that there is any universe where the current KSI takes down the mountain, even just simply in terms of stamina. That type of strategy that I just laid out for the past however many minutes is extremely taxing on your cardio. It is exhausting. It is non-stop, constant work. The second that bell goes, you start punching, you start moving, and you do not stop. And I just don't think someone like KSI has the stamina to keep that up. Now, I'm sure a few of you at least are wondering, well, Eli, do you think you could do it? And my answer to that is yes and no. Yes, because I do think, just based off my own personal experiences, that I would be able to pull it off. Now, being able to do it and it being likely are two very different things. Like I said, you basically have to be perfect, one wrong move, and he punches my torso in the next week. And I mean that literally, just boom, this is gone, head, arms and legs remain, body's gone. Come back a week, body's there. Don't know how it happened, it's just happened. But based off of my own experiences, I have fought people who, one of my sparring partners was a 6'4", again, still not as tall as the mountain, but 6'4", 280 pounds. And the way I fought him was that aggressive style. And by the end of it, he said that I was the only person he had ever fought that wasn't scared of getting hit. And it threw him off. He would hit me, or he would, and I'd block it, or I'd take it in the arms, or I'd duck it, right? And he'd hit me, and he'd just go, "This guy's still coming after me." He hit me again. "He's still coming after me." So he hit me harder. He's not stopping, harder and harder, until eventually he was giving me everything he had, and he's going, I'm punching this guy as hard as I possibly can. He's just did 20 minutes of straight rounds with the best fighter in our club, and he's still coming after me. And by the end of it, he was exhausted, because it's hard keeping that kind of pressure off you. So I do have experience dealing with people who are immensely bigger than me and who know how to fight. Now again, do I think that it is probable that I'm going to win? No. Like, I'd have to be an idiot to think that, but luckily I am an idiot. So if I were ever given the opportunity to spar someone like The Mountain or Eddie Hall, I would take it in a heartbeat, because I'd love to test my mettle against someone just that size. It's not even that skill caliber, it's just someone that big. Let's see how I can, you know, withstand the punches. But anyway, that's really all I have to say for this video. Hope you found it enjoyable. I would like to thank you all for 2,000 subscribers, as well as helping me get monetized. I do plan to do some sort of subscriber special. If you have any ideas for that, leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, I might just do a Q&A, but along with thank yous, I would like to thank everybody who supports me on Patreon. I'm going through some tough times monetarily now. I seem to say that a lot because I am. So your support, even in just a moral sense, means the world to me. Thank you very much. But until the next one, I am not dead yet. If you want to support me, all my links are in the description. Forgot to say that. And if you are not either, remember, only the strong subscribe, and there's always a tomorrow waiting for you.